If you didn't know about the autocomplete feature in your terminal, you will want to. It is easy to learn, quick to master, and so incredibly useful in all sorts of day-to-day tasks. Alright, let's just say I need to open this directory where we have GNOME Shell extensions, for instance. Just look at how fast I can type in this command. The secret to this? I press tab. A lot. And you can too. Welcome to Nick's Tricks. I am Nick, and this is Tab Completion. How's it going, guys? Today we're going to talk about a simple yet powerful feature that can help you improve the way you type almost everything. The way this basically works in a CLI is you start to type something, then you just press tab and it'll automatically fill in the rest of the thing for you. The first implementation of a such mechanism actually dates back to the mid-60s, little fun fact right there. Since the late 90s, however, tab completion has been publicly available in all sorts of command line interfaces. It has in fact become so popular that today it is built in every major distro. It is everywhere, mainly and conveniently because of two reasons. It is fast and it is error-free. Statistically, everything you type by hand will take you about twice as long, and there's always the chance of typos, and then the challenge of blindly guessing and second-guessing file names or commands and their arguments and so on. But no more. Let us dive into some use cases and real-life examples. File system navigation. This one is about accessing files or navigating through complex directory structures, and we've already seen a brief example in the intro to this video, but let's see exactly how this works. From my home directory, I'm going to show all directories first, and I'm looking at Downloads, Desktop, and Documents. Now if I type CD, capital D, and I press Tab once, nothing happens. This means there are multiple matches for stuff starting with capital D. I can either press Tab again to see a list of those matches, or type the next letter to help narrow it down. I press Tab, and I see all three directories. Continuing to press tab would only keep displaying the same results. I have to change whatever I'm typing into something that will eventually return only one result. That's the win state. If I were to press E, the only match is desktop, so it completed it for me, and now I can press enter to get into it, and that's already so cool. Now let's go back and see this one more time before we move on with this example. Let's look at the other two directories, documents and downloads, right? O and tab, I get two options. I can press W and tab to have it narrow it down to one option. And once again, I can press enter to change the directory, or notice the trailing slash, I can press tab again to see a list of all matches inside downloads. Oh, and this obviously works with other commands as well. Here's an example of how you would open the main Bluetooth configuration file. vim/e/tab/bl/tab/m/tab/enter, done. Feel free to experiment with all of this on your own. I find it very useful for quickly copying or editing files, archiving them, creating symlinks, and so on. Commands, subcommands, and their options. This works with any executable from your current or global path, and let's just jump into some examples. I'm typing SC and hitting tab a couple of times to see all the commands I have available to me, starting with SC. Let's try apt, the default package manager for all Debian-based distros. Most used commands, yeah. I can just apt space tab and get a list of all apt commands, just like that. And then start typing one of them and press tab again to autocomplete. Same goes for git, look at all of these commands and git help. Alright, and here's the last one. You could look through Firefox's runtime options and start it. The standard behavior in Bash is that you have to press tab twice whenever there are multiple matching completions. While I prefer this, you should know there are a couple of alternative behaviors to choose from. In this mode, the list of all matches is hidden and you press tab to cycle through the matches. To make this the default for your current user, you can edit or create the input RC file. RC stands for runtime configuration. Add this line here and save. The other one is always show all matches. In this mode, pressing tab will display all matches regardless of their number. To configure this, just make sure to have this line instead of the whole one in your input RC. Now, before we wrap this video up, I'd like to make a quick disclaimer. There are more sophisticated shells and terminal emulators out there, some that even provide auto-suggest and autocomplete powered by AI. While that is certainly fun, I personally like to keep things minimal and draw the line as close as comfortably possible to whatever is the out-of-box experience. Tap completion is great, but it's basic. Or perhaps for some, it's great because it is basic. I really hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. There's more where that came from, so you can subscribe and hit all the right buttons to stay tuned, which would also help support the channel. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.